If you follow my channel, you know that I love to make videos about players with very interesting stories. Some of them make it to the NBA while others fall short, but either way, their experiences and journeys are all unique. Today, we're going to take a look at a 7'9" basketball player from North Korea, and according to Sports Illustrated, he was the tallest basketball player in the history of the sport. Yes, even taller than Sun Ming, who I made a video on before. He was half an inch taller than him, which is just crazy. What's good, fellas? My name's Andy, and in this video, I'm gonna talk about Ri Myung-Hun, the North Korean who nearly made it to the NBA, if it weren't for some political obstacles, to say the least. He was born in 1967 in North Korea, and at first, he wasn't a big basketball fan. But as he grew older and taller, he quickly became a huge fan of it. His favorite player was none other than the great Michael Jordan. And after watching him dominate the league for so many years, Ri actually wanted people to start calling him Michael. A lot of Asians overseas like to Americanize their names if they plan on moving to the US. That's how much of a fan he was, because he got it from Jordan. Once he got into it, Ri started to really love to play basketball, and his goal was to eventually make it to the NBA, but the problem was, it was kinda hard for him to get discovered. I mean, he was living in North Korea, and it's not like NBA scouts frequently take trips there to find prospects. But in 1998, that would actually happen, by a guy named Tony Ronzone, who was working for FIBA, but he was also a scout for the Dallas Mavericks. He was invited to hold a basketball clinic in North Korea, which was kinda weird, but at the time, the US wanted to build a better relationship with North Korea through basketball. However, Ronzone could have just not accepted the invitation, but he did for a different reason. He heard through the grapevine that a giant 7'9" tall basketball player was living in North Korea, and he wanted to watch him play. Apparently, despite being huge, Ri did not play like he was that big. According to Ronzone, Ri had a smooth jump shot and great fundamentals, even though he could just dunk over everyone without even jumping. It wasn't until late 1998 that North Korean leader Kim Jong-il allowed Ri to leave the country to play basketball elsewhere. When Ri first left North Korea, he was given a coach and trainers, and the first place he went to was Canada, where he started working out and training to hopefully get recognized and make it to the NBA. He was already over 30 years old at this point, so it would be really difficult, but believe it or not, he actually drew some interest from several teams. It was probably because he was gigantic, but still, he had a chance. And this was it. During Ri's workouts in Canada, he displayed all of his talent and skills to the scouts that came to see him play. And he actually surprised them a bit because he was pretty good. He sparked their interest and some teams were actually considering signing him. But there was a problem, which I mentioned earlier, that was out of his control. He was not allowed to play in the NBA. This is because in 1917, the United States passed a federal law called the Trading with the Enemy Act of 1917, which basically banned them from trading with hostile countries like North Korea at the time. However, the US Department of State overruled this act and allowed Ri to come to the States to play in the NBA, as long as Ri's salary does not get sent to the North Korean government. And this is where disagreements started. North Korea leader Kim Jong-il did not like this idea, and he responded by not allowing Ri to go to the NBA. So then the US and North Korea could not reach an agreement, and the negotiations reached a stalemate. Eventually, Kim came up with another idea, and he decided to give Ri the chance to play there. But in return, he demanded that the team he played for must pay North Korea back in, not money, but wheat. So let's say Ri joined the Dallas Mavericks. Kim Jong-il wanted the Mavs to compensate him by paying the country wheat. It's kinda funny when you think about it, but nothing came out of this deal. Ri ended up never coming to the NBA because neither sides were able to come to an agreement, which is kinda disappointing. I mean, he probably would not have been an amazing player, but it would be kinda cool to see the first North Korean player play in the NBA. In an interview around that time, Ri stated that he thought if he could play in the NBA, it could create a better relationship between the US and North Korea, but it looks like it backfired. He wanted to play in the NBA to test his skills and try to see what he can do. He wasn't interested in the money. And later on, he also said that even though he couldn't play there, he still had a great life in North Korea because of Kim Jong-il. So besides his whole situation, Ri also played a game in Seoul, along with a bunch of other North and South Koreans, where he scored 26 points. The main purpose of this game was to create a better relationship between the two countries. But Ri turned out to be the center of attention because he was so massive. He towered over everyone. The people there burst into laughter when Ri held up the ball and other players tried to jump and get it. Afterwards, he did not really make any more public appearances. He returned to North Korea and just lived his normal life there. But in 2011, when Kim Jong-il passed away, there was a very interesting photo that came out during the funeral. You see a group of normal soldiers, but then you see one soldier that looked huge. Most people had no idea who Ri Myung-Hun was, so they thought this picture was photoshopped. But then later on, it's been speculated that this guy was really Ri Myung-Hun. We knew he was really close friends with Kim, so it's certainly possible. And that's all, folks. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't yet, and I'll see y'all next time.